license and registration, please.
For what? I was minding my own business. I have not violated any laws. Am I free to go?
Sir, I'm gonna ask you again for your license and registration.
Brent, your job as a lawyer is very unappealing to me. As my senior advisor, I need you to get this done.
Individuals can only give a maximum donation of $5,619.
Senior pastor and spiritual leader, Dr. Rowe.
Yeah, man. Okay, we get it. You're Marco. What I don't understand is all of the social media bullshit you just posted on your page.
I spoke with his publicist, Lee, right before he disappeared, and she said that he was working with some marketing guy, Jamil.
Jamil Charles-Stanton?
What? AGTV, you're from Florida, correct?
Yeah, Miami.
Man, me too.
Word?
It's gonna be great work with another brother from the MIA.
Right, man. This is definitely gonna be a good look.
Most definitely.
See? I knew this would work. Off to a good start.
The head hunter, I presume?
Excuse me? Have a little respect for the mother of your child.
Jesus Christ, what the hell are you doing, man?
It's all right there in the hard drive. How did you get this? Have you forgotten? I graduated top of my class from Stanford. I have 5 degrees. Getting research on Jamil's campaign was like doing research on a midterm paper. Piece of cake.
But just remember, this slut makes or break you. The wedding invitation goes out on my time. Have the marriage license ready for me to sign by tonight.
I can wire this money directly from this account into our super PAC.
And from the super PAC into our account, right?
Exactly. Okay. And I'm not even breaking any laws.
I am a very busy man. What am I doing here? What is this meeting about?
It's all over the news, Jamil.
What's all over the news?
It. My husband and I were disgusted. Fix it now.
Fix what?
He was removed from his office early this morning.
Pastor Rosen?
Now I need him removed permanently.
Look. I am running for governor. God damn it, find somebody else to do your dirty work.
Think of your company as that boat, the Titanic.
You threatening me?
Think of Pastor Rosen as your iceberg. Destroy it before it destroys you.
It destroys me?
No, Jamil, don't take that man's life. It's not necessary. No. Fuck that, Neil. That's nonsense.
Get your hands off of me. Just who in the hell do you think you are?
Thank you.
How may I help you? No, I mean, I should not be getting this call 2 weeks ago, according to a Georgia law. I mean, well, shouldn't that information be on your computer screen? Look, save your apologies. I don't need it right now. Well, I'm a decorated civil rights attorney for the late Michael Preston, a black man who was murdered for no apparent reason by a white man. Judge Monroe violated my First Amendment. Okay, what does my race have to do with anything? Hello? Unbelievable.
I'm Dominic Rothschild, and this is another Under the Tree Minute. Now, we're not gonna talk about any of your celebrities like Beyonce, the queen who was everything, but we're gonna go live in a couple of minutes downtown as it's reported that Jamil Charles-Stanton is going to announce his candidacy for governor of the state of Georgia. Now, I'm thinking that the feed is there. We're gonna cut to the feed as soon as it's happening. But just give me a minute to set things up and we'll be right here at UnderTree.com. Honey, it seems a lot of things is happening down there, but that podium is still empty. So I'm gonna cut down to Bolt, who is live on the scene, and he's gonna talk to Jamil Charles-Stanton, senior advisor. Bolt?
We have about 10 seconds before the man who promises to clean up our beautiful city and make it even prettier comes to see us. But let's be real. Does your candidate really stand a chance against Mayor Powers? I mean, he's already ahead in the polls and he hasn't even announced his candidacy.
Let's start by addressing the opposition. Mayor Adrian Powers. He is weak and pathetic. Big leagues? Look at him. He has allowed certain members of our community to live up under the poverty lines. When I become governor, this will end. The mayor has publicly disgraced our men and women in blue, our great police force. These illegals, it's a problem. They are all criminals. When I become governor, I will demand absolute law and order. When I become governor, and I will, they are gone. Out of here. And this HIV/AIDS epidemic, it's everywhere. It's just like the illegals. We have to get control of this situation. And this radio Islamic terrorism. Anybody with a beard half the size of Osama bin Laden's will be out of this state. We have to protect our residents. Now get out there on November the 8th and vote for the only candidate that can protect you against the Muslims. God bless you. God bless you, and God bless this great state of Georgia.
So what you're saying is he had a look of guilt on his face?
Now the nigga killed my cousin is what I'm saying. I felt that shit.
Jayden was under investigation for a triple homicide before he disappeared. You got out of prison early so that you can help us catch him. But if what you're saying is true, we've been looking at the wrong person all along.
Yeah, you have. My cousin was innocent, and I have proof that Jamil is guilty.
What is that?
Look.
Where did you get those? Never mind where you got it from. I need you to get some information on Jamil. I need you to wear a wire.
I mean, I can, I guess.
Yeah, we gotta make it happen. We gotta catch him.
All right, I have it. I got some connection.
I remember like it was yesterday. Me and my fiance, we had taken a trip back in high school to Jersey. But before we got there, she said that she had something important to tell me.
What did she tell you?
She said, I think my brother, that's who we're supposed to be staying with while we were there, is on the down low.
How did that make you feel?
And I asked her why she think that, and she said, well, him and his best friend are a little too close. I said, well, aren't all best friends supposed to be close? She said, yeah, but they sleep in the same bed. Now, me being from the South, I saw nothing wrong with that. Yeah, me and my cousins, we slept in the same bed for years.
So you didn't find that odd?
Not right away, at least. Then we get there. I met her brother, her brother's best friend. They even introduced me to her brother's girlfriend. I mean, everything seemed normal. He nor his best friend looked gay.
Do you believe that all gay people look a certain way?
No. Look, I grew up in a small town, and the openly gay guys that lived there were flamboyant. Our brother, he was masculine. His friends were thugs, drug dealers, hood type. So, one day, my fiance and her best friends, her brother, they left to go grocery shopping. And then it happened.
What happened?
My sister and dad went out?
Yeah. They went grocery shopping.
Cool. So Nigel, how long have you and my sister been dating?
About a year and a half now.
You love her?
Of course. I proposed to her. I want to marry her. Out of nowhere, he asked me the most outlandish question.
Have you ever been with a dude before?
No, I haven't. Masturbating right in front of me.
So how did that make you feel, Nigel? Nigel.
I froze. But I felt myself coming aroused. It was kind of like taboo. I felt dirty almost. But it was intriguing.
So you felt something?
Yeah. It piqued my curiosity.
Did you act on your curiosity?
No. But that moment, it's been replaying in the back of my mind for 10 years. Festering, lingering, developing into a malignant tumor that will eventually spread.
So you're saying what, Nigel?
I'm not a faggot.
No one said that.
I know. But this craving to be physical with another man is becoming unbearable. I love my wife. I do. But I'm beginning to weaken. And, you know, it's kind of like a kid a mother has to tell a million times not to do something. But eventually he does. I think a part of me is looking for validation. A sign. Something. Even a reason to act off what I've been feeling inside. I can't do this. I can't. I'm sorry.
Good evening. I'm bringing you breaking news with a bruised heart and, well, so much sorrow. I can confirm without hesitation that Pastor Rosen has been reported missing. However, and this is where things get a little complicated, it seems that the facts of his disappearance became unclear. At first we thought it was due to his recent battle with cancer, but it turns out that it could be his recent posts on social media about his provocative and derogatory terms about the LGBTQ community. Well, and that sparked the interest of everyone, an emotional experience as well, and well, the mayor's even released a statement on it. So, and at this point, this just in, Pastor Rosen has lost his battle with cancer. He passed away earlier today at Mercy Medical. Well, at this point, I think we're gonna pass it back to Dominic.
Now, get out.
I can always come back, because it seems like should I reschedule?
I'm sorry, MJ. I apologize. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
You look great. I'm doing great. Have a seat. I really do apologize. I'm sorry.
That outburst had anything to do with my brother?
To a lesser extent. Look, I was just furious at Judge Monroe. Look, he ordered my removal from his courtroom because I had a Black Lives Matter pin on.
He did what? That's systematic racism.
Exactly.
And total nonsense about a way that cop that took my brother's life will never be indicted, no matter how good you are at your job. This is what they do all the time. They only charge him initially just to shut up the Black community. But we aren't always getting away with murder. Look. I so did not come here to talk about my brother. I came here to trade secrets.
Okay, look, I understand that, but this is not the place right now to talk about that.
No, this is so the place for it.
Okay, the mayor and I are worried about your super PAC. We're worried about the process. How are we gonna find out how much the donors are contributing?
You don't, unless you ask each donor individually. But you can do for all I care.
Okay, well, why don't I just ask you, since you're right here?
Let's clear this up real quick. Oh my God, he's fucking confused. I am providing you and the mayor a service because the state of Georgia prohibits you from providing it yourself. I am not your accountant. These donors are my clients too. And I have to protect their privacy.
Okay, well, they were my clients before they became your
That's
clients.
Not the fucking point.
Okay, well, what is the point? Because right now you're stuttering.
You take orders from me, not the other way around. And let's not forget this is my pack. It would be wise not to irritate me.
It would be wise for you to wipe that insolence dripping from your mouth. Who do you think you're talking to?
Insolence? Go ahead. Wipe it.
You're not worthy. And you're not the only one in America who can create a super PAC, MJ.
But I bet I was the only one in the country that was able to hack into the mayor's database. And now let's just say, I have information on you and him that would destroy your career and sink him out of his race to make governor. I own you, nigga.
Let's get one thing straight. You have nothing on me.
I have one word for you. WikiLeaks.
And I have one word for you. Blackmail. As an attorney with the Atlanta Bar, you are aware that blackmail is a criminal offense, right?
Except I'm blackmailing no one. Just a simple business transaction, girl. Welcome to Atlanta, bitch. You will make sure the mayor transfers 25% of all donations specifically from this account for governor. I studied your past. Brent, I know the secrets in your closet. And most of all, I know you won't disappoint me.
Atlanta's most prominent businessman, music mogul Jayden Woodard, is still missing.
What's best for us? Best for us? What are you talking about?
No. This is gonna be bad. This is gonna be really, really bad. This is Jamil. This is a bad idea. Just don't listen to Jamil. This is a bad idea. It's a bad idea.
Shut the fuck up, you pussy. Man up.
Don't talk to him like that. You know he's fragile. You know what you do to him.
HD, you ready for your performance?
What performance? I mean, that's only like 20 people up in this bit.
Come on, don't be like that. You gotta start somewhere.
But Jayden said...
I don't care what Jayden says. Just because he's your cousin and he signed you to the label isn't gonna make you an instant star.
But...
No buts. I am the head publicist of the grind. I know what it takes to make this work. We'll take photos with all 20 people and make it look like the club is filled. I'll get images of your performance. I'll send a nice write-up to the blogs. By tomorrow morning, you'll be the new it rapper on the block. So trust, sit tight. I gotta make a few phone calls. You know, me and your cousin Jayden was pretty close.
My who? Hey man, I don't got family over here like that.
Look, don't play these games with me. I know all about you and your felony convictions.
Hey man, don't come at me like that. Now you already know I don't sacrifice a lot for my mistakes, Lee. So I'm still trying to understand why the hell are you even still here reminding me of them?
Look, I think you have your thems mixed up. I'm not your little boyfriend, Spence. So you watch who you talk to like that. Look, I know you're going through a lot trying to figure out who killed Jayden. That's why I'm here.
I don't care what you got. I got this. And you need to get dead.
Get this over to Mr. Evanson, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll do. And just so you know, your numbers are up. So our plan...
Camilla, can I ask you a question?
Yeah, sure, I'm all ears.
Why did you decide you wanted to work for me?
Well, that's easy. Marcela, you are a strong and beautiful black woman. Breaking barriers in the political realm, you are making history. That in itself is inspiring. You're a black woman, paving the way for all women in a male-dominated world. There should be more women like you. Can I share something personal with you?
Yes, you may.
Well, as you know, I come from a well-put-together family. Privileged, esteemed, educated, well-to-do. My dad was and still is this controlling tyrant of a man. You know, he still believes that a woman's place should be inside the home and that a man's place is taking care of the household. And my mom still buys into that philosophy to this day. Heartbreaking. You know, he's even had affairs on my mom. And do you know what she did?
What?
She still could.
Marcela, why do you have me out here like a streetwalker, honey? What do you want?
Oh, Dominic, come right in and have a seat. You're right on time.
Yes, girl, always on time.
Dominic Rothschild III. Well, I haven't seen you in years.
Yes, and Marcela, I haven't seen you since you were terrorizing me my freshman year in college. I survived that without committing suicide. But girl, how you doing? What's up with you?
Come on, Dominic. I was not that bad. You survived, and look at you now. Primetime television.
Yes, honey, we go on my resume all night. The blogs.
Can I interrupt for a second?
Oh, girl, who is this?
Well, just to update you, me and Marcela came up with a plan.
Marcela and I continue.
We're going to announce our candidacy tomorrow on the new Millennials show. And here's how it's going to work. It's going to allow us to have this national platform for exposure. And for you, well, you have the opportunity to gain new viewership.
First of all, my sweet thing, don't plan things on my show, okay? And honey, do I hear that you need me?
Let's not say need, but let's just call it a collaboration.
Well, a collaboration is two parts, so you would have to have a treat for me if you won't dominate, honey. Now, New Millennials is my show, and I built that up myself. I employ hundreds of people, from the men that drive my cars, to the men that bring me coffee, to the men that write my scripts, to the men that work my cameras, and monitor my website. So, how can you help me, honey?
What if I said I could give you pertinent information on Jamil that you can leak during his campaign?
Okay, how are you gonna do that?
Abuse, drugs, recordings of his outbursts, records of his mental illness.
Jamil, tell me more.
Well, you see, my sole reason for wanting to run for governor of Georgia is not for the notoriety of the fame. No. I simply want to help the people of this great state of Georgia. This is my purpose. This is my passion. However, I suffered something a few years back that was so traumatic, so tragic that I almost lost the love with. Yeah, I'll admit, I got caught up. I got involved with a psychopathic, narcissistic, womanizing, mentally, physically abusive, self-hating black man who absolutely hates black women. This man, this demon that I speak of, is so vile, so destructive that he'll do anything to get his way. I mean, he almost killed me. Quite frankly, I want to see him crumble. Yeah, he can't get away with what he did to me. I dated this man for 2 years. This man, this monster I speak of, is Jamil Charles-Stanton.
I see.
I was not expecting you so soon. But now that you're here, we need to talk. I don't want you meeting up with that loser anymore.
First off, losers, I don't do. And for two, who are you talking about?
The mayor. That loser.
Why not?
You haven't seen the footage, have you? Let's just say there's footage out there of the mayor in a pretty compromising situation with another man.
I don't get it. What does that have to do with me?
What do you mean you don't? Nima, it has everything to do with you. Your reputation, your integrity. Why would you want to be connected with someone like him? Let's face it, I'm a much bigger man. Come on.
What are you saying?
What am I? The connection. I know you feel it. I need you by my side. I want you to make me a better man. Nima, be my first lady.
First lady?
Yes. I saw you smiling earlier during the press conference. You know I'm running for governor. Come on now.
Congrats. Again. But what about my development project? Only the mayor can sign off on that.
The mayor? Don't worry about the mayor. I have him in my back pocket. Trust me, he's on Jamil's payroll now. It's handled. Who is that?
And who is calling you at this hour?
Excuse me? First off, respect my radius. And right now, you're all in it.
I have to go. I'll be back.
What? Nima, get back here.
I have to go.
Nima, get your ass back here.
You have reached a number that has been disconnected. We're sorry, you have reached a number that has been disconnected. We're sorry, you have reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service. If you feel you have...
Jamil, can I come out and play tonight?
No. No! You cannot come out. Don't you know I'm running for governor now? I have to be in my best behavior. Everybody's watching me. All eyes are on Jamil.
You'll slip up. You'll slip up and I'll be gonna catch you. Bitch, you need me. And don't forget it.
No, you can't. No. Leave me alone! Get out of my head! You're not real! You're not real!
Ricky.
I gotta get rid of you.
I am very much real. And if you have a shred of a chance of winning this election, it's gonna be because of me!
Stop!
Pussy! Look at you! You're weak and you're pathetic! You're gonna lose this fucking election! You're gonna go back to your little, simple life where nobody fucking knows you.